By the time I got to the other side of my head, my hair had basically dried. I go ahead and spray water and then add about 2 dimes of the Giovanni's Direct Leave-In Conditioner per section. I detangle a bit more. Spray the hair, add the bands, and seal my ends with an oil concoction of olive oil, coconut oil, and jojoba oil before adding the perm rods. Now, I made these satin wrapped to protect my ends at night. Fancy, right? So I'm all done. Now my next step is add about a dime to a nickel size of the Shea Moisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie plus a dab, and I do mean a dab, a very thin layer of the Shea Moisture Curling Soufflé. I found that this is good for use as a holding agent, the Shea Moisture Curling Soufflé, but definitely do not overdo it. I then twist down until the last about inch and a half of my hair. Then I recurl the dry hair, dry twist with perm rods. I find that this gives me a nice loose curl that I like. Now that that's finished, I give my hair an all over spray with the Shea Moisture Elixir. I tie it all down with my netting in a silk or satin scarf, whichever you have on hand. I had a silk one at that time. And since I sleep on a satin pillowcase, my twists basically stay smooth while I sleep.
Hey, so I'm back and I'm ready to do the final takedown for this look of a dry twist out. And I just had my hair back in a ponytail because I was working out earlier. And I did cut out a couple of the rubber bands just because I wanted to see, you know, what it was looking like in there. I normally, when I do the dry twist out, don't leave the rubber bands in. I kind of flat twist the top part, and then you know, just regular twist the rest of the way down. I just left the rubber bands in this time because I kind of wanted to see, you know, that was going to make a difference in the way that my hair came out. So I'm just cutting these out. You probably saw me earlier taking down, when I was taking the bands out, the banding, I just slid the rubber bands off, but since these are pretty high up and obviously I have twists in my hair, I'm just cutting them out. I guess you could, you know, unravel them if you wanted to, but I just find with them being this far up, the twist is just easier to cut them. And of course, you want to be careful not to cut your hair, because that wouldn't be cute. But I know some people are probably out there saying, oh, the black little rubber bands, they're so not good for your hair, blah, blah, blah. But really, when I pull the bands out, hardly any, if at all, hair comes out, because I make sure that I soak the rubber bands in some kind of oil concoction before putting them in. And the ones that go down the length of my hair don't stay in but for a couple of hours, just long enough for the hair to completely dry. And you know, this is my first time leaving these bands in like this all night. The last time I banded my hair, well, the first time in my initial video, was with some different type of rubber bands. They were the elastic, colorful kind. So, alright, I think this is the last one. Pretty much. Yeah, I don't feel any more, so I'm gonna just start untwisting here. Now, you'll notice I'm not using any oil for this takedown. I will spray the twist a little with my Shea Moisture Elixir oil. And that's the oil that I use when and if I choose to press my hair. I find that it's a lot lighter than my homemade concoction of oil, which is very moisturizing and it's good. I usually use olive oil, coconut oil, and jojoba oil. Mix that together. It's predominantly olive oil, though my hair seems to prefer that. But yeah, because I just want like a more flowy, I guess, look, I'm gonna use the oil that I would normally use, like if my hair were pressed, which is the Shea Moisture Elixir, and I'll show you that in a moment. But you know, as you saw earlier, I went ahead and there's one more rubber band. I went ahead and filled my ends with my homemade oil, and my hair still feels pretty moisturized from when I did that. So I don't really think I need to add much more to it. Just, you know, hit the ends probably. And these twists are coming apart very easily, which is nice. I think I mentioned in my last video that I've had like a reduction in single strand knots since I've been doing this style, so that's pretty cool. So, alright, all the twists are out. I'm just going to give it a little spray here on the ends with the Reconstructive Elixir by Shea Moisture. And I'm gonna take these apart, and when I come back I will show you the final look. Alright, so I'm back, and here is the finished look. I'm pretty happy with these results. Yeah, so just have it pinned back, the front part. Kind of grown to be my signature look. I think I'll rock this style pretty often, so I'll show you the back. Well, you can see that, and I think it came out pretty good. I'm happy with the results this time. You know, I used all of my natural sort of products, like my Giovanni's, my Shea Moisture, the curling souffle, and just a dab of the curling souffle, because that stuff can get icky. But when I dry twisted it, you know, combined it with that and the, what's the other one? The curling souffle and whatever it's called. I can't remember the name in the description box. And I think I also have a slide for it earlier in the video. So it came out pretty good. I'm happy with the results, and try the style. Let me know if you like it. Banding plus dry twisting. It's a good look, I think. So one more thing before I go. I just want to let you all know that I do have a blog. I would love for you to come and visit me over on Tumblr. The address is www.sassynation.tumblr.com. And Sassy Nation also has a Facebook page. You can get on there. It's The Sassy Nation. And check out the page. I'd love to see you in some other social networks. Alright, so thanks for watching, and as always, if you like the video, please go ahead and check like and subscribe, and keep checking back for more videos. See you soon.